Dozens volunteered at the 6th annual Care for the Cape and Islands Day at Mass Audubon's Long Pasture Wildlife Sanctuary in Cumaquid.
CARE's mission is to inspire stewardship to preserve and protect the natural environment, cultural and historic places on Cape Cod. One of the great things about what we do at CARE Day is every year we invite people to spend a half day giving back and doing service. And then at lunch we announce who our grant recipients are for this year. This is a great way for us to inspire stewardship. And it's just so important for us to take care of this special place. Because if we don't, who will?
Today is our annual CARE Day for Cape Cod, with lots of volunteers helping us prepare various aspects of the sanctuary for the busy season. We have a slew of spring cleaning projects, including patching holes in our driveway, things as simple as that, to things that are a little more around our mission.
We get a lot of work done with these projects. It's just a matter of how much time we have available and how many hands.
Many of the volunteers were past and present CARE grant recipients. With CARE's help, the Food Forest Initiative put the final touches on their edible garden.
This is the site of the Food Forest demonstration garden that was planted with a grant from CARE for Cape and Islands to Audubon and to Food Forest Initiative of Cape Cod.
The theme here is native and edible or useful plants. We think it's important to create not only a sustainable food system, but a regenerative food system that is sequestering carbon and building soil and creating more and more food every year. That's the beauty of trees. They just keep getting bigger and bigger and producing more food. And so this is just a little model of what we could really scale up and do more of here on Cape Cod, but anywhere really in the world.
In addition to Mass Audubon and the Food Forest Initiative, CARE has awarded several grants that work to reduce plastic use.
We funded already 5 water bottle filling stations throughout the Cape, and so we're giving grants today for 2 more.
We were lucky enough to get a grant from CARE for our proposed water bottle refill stations, where you bring your reusable water bottle and thereby avoid the use of single-use plastic bottles, which is a very big deal these days. And where we want to put these water bottles, we've got 3 locations in town we proposed, and we're going to go before town meeting next week, and hopefully it'll be approved there. All the response has been very positive.
The White Shark Conservancy also received a grant.
So the Conservancy received a grant from CARE this past year to help us at our outreach facility, the Chatham Shark Center. So this grant is going to fund a water fountain with a water bottle filling station, as well as 2 bike racks for outdoor art facility. We realize that we are on one of the bike trails in Chatham, and so we really want to promote to families that they can visit us by way of bike. We also have a lot of families who are coming in the summer months, and we really want to support that idea of reusable water bottles.
And in celebration of the 400th anniversary of the Pilgrim Landing, CARE also awarded a grant to the Cape Cod Museum Trail.
With our 400th anniversary coming up, they're doing a trail that's specifically around the Pilgrims, and to remind people that the Pilgrims actually landed here before they went on to Plymouth.
We are creating a mini trail to celebrate 2020 next year with the Pilgrims' arrival, and so it's called the Cape Cod Pilgrim Trail, and we are documenting where they've gone, what museums they can go to see the history of the Pilgrims and the Native Americans that were living here, and the different spots that the Pilgrims stopped while they were here on the Cape.
Since 2013, CARE for the Cape and Islands has awarded more than 40 grants that further their mission to preserve and protect the natural beauty of Cape Cod.
We're very grateful for CARE to give us the capacity to create exhibits and to just build in sustainability into the sanctuary. And CARE has been generous to give to a lot of smaller startups here. So proportionately, their grants can have a major impact.
It's been really incredible working with the team at CARE. We feel very fortunate and we're very grateful for their support. We've learned a lot through the network that they've created.
They have validated us and helped us and helped it get moving. And that's always incredibly rewarding.
The 6th annual CARE for the Cape and Islands Day was held on May 9th in Cumaquid. For Cape Media News, I'm Gabrielle Rawson.